Today I have a very ambitious paper from three physicists who claim they've solved one of the greatest mysteries of physics, why cats are either dead or alive, but not both. Let's have a look. Schrödinger's famous cat is a thought experiment meant to illustrate the absurd consequences of quantum physics. You see, in the mathematics of quantum physics, everything, let's say a particle, is described by a wave function, usually denoted psi. Depending on just what the particle's doing, its wave function will be different. We could have a wave function describing the particle going left and one describing it going right. The odd thing is now that in quantum mechanics, once you have that, the mathematics also allows for a particle that's the sum of going left and going right. This is called a superposition. And what even is that? Now you could say that, well, doesn't really matter because these odd things only happen in the tiny quantum range where we don't see it, so who cares? But not so fast, Schrödinger said, because we can amplify these superpositions from the small to the large. He said, let's suppose we have an atom that's in a superposition of decayed and not decayed. If it's decayed, then that decay triggers the release of some toxic substance, which kills a cat. So now the cat must be both dead and alive. But why do we never observe this? In the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, which the authors of the new paper use, the problem presents itself somewhat differently. In that interpretation, the cat's dead in one universe and alive in another one. The problem is then why there isn't any one universe in which the cat is both dead and alive. Who or what selects what's allowed in a universe? The quantum vet? Probably not. Physicists have tried to get rid of this problem by blaming a process called decoherence. Decoherence is the loss of coherence, a phenomenon that you can observe in your local pub past 8 p.m., but that more importantly scrambles up quantum effects so that they become impossible to measure. This scrambling is caused by interactions with the environment that might be air molecules or just quanta of light, the photons. Or so they say, because that doesn't properly work. Decoherence basically tells you which states are still allowed after quantum effects have been destroyed. The trouble is, though, that the answer you get depends on what assumptions you make about the environment. If you take an environment like the one we find ourselves in, what with air and light and so on, then cats are either dead or alive. Hooray!
Hooray!
But just mathematically, there are environments in which dead and alive is an allowed result of decoherence. What this means is that decoherence just turns the question of why the cat is never both dead and alive into the question of why the environment of the cat is the way that it is, which we don't have an answer to either. So decoherence just moves the problem from the cat into the environment of the cat, which really explains a lot about cats, doesn't it? And this is where the new paper becomes relevant, because the authors say that they've solved this problem. They say they've found a way in which a system that's combined of a quantum state, that would be the dead and alive cat, and an arbitrary environment, unambiguously selects the states that we actually observe. The way that they go about this is with a little mathematical model that you see sketched in this figure. They have two big systems that you can think of as the cat being dead and the cat being alive. They could also be in the state of the cat being dead and alive, which is what you don't want to happen. These two states have some interaction between them. That's this red region that they describe by using random matrices. Their results are what you see in this figure, where the horizontal lines are the classical states, so the dead and alive cat, basically. You can see that for a variety of initial states, the entire system always ends up where it's supposed to, dead or alive, but if you wait long enough, nothing in between. In the many worlds interpretation, this explains why we find ourselves only in universes where cats are either dead or alive. By the way, this video comes with a quiz that lets you check how much you remember. Problem solved. It looks like it. But, I'm pretty sure that the original problem, that there is always an environment that gives rise to a dead and alive cat, is a mathematical truism. If that doesn't happen in their setup, it means that their result depends on the assumptions they've made about the system. Unfortunately, the paper didn't contain enough details for me to check this. So I think this is a very interesting result, if it's correct, because it has solved a huge problem. But I'm very skeptical that it's indeed correct, and I doubt that this is the last we'll hear about dead and alive cats, so don't forget to subscribe. They say that no one understands quantum mechanics. I think it's not true. It's totally understandable. If you want to give it a try yourself, check out my quantum mechanics course on brilliant.org. My course will help you understand what a wave function is and what the difference is between superpositions and entanglement. It also covers interference, the uncertainty principle, and Bell's theorem. And after that, you can continue maybe with their course on quantum computing or differential equations. All courses on Brilliant have interactive visualizations and come with follow-up questions. I found it to be very effective to learn something new. It really gives you a feeling for what's going on and helps you build general problem-solving skills. They cover a large variety of topics in science, computer science, and maths, from general scientific thinking to dedicated courses on differential equations or large language models. And they're adding new courses each month. It's a fast and easy way to learn, and you can do it whenever and wherever you have the time. And of course, I have a special offer for users of this channel. If you use my link brilliant.org/Sabine, you'll get to try out everything Brilliant has to offer for a full 30 days. And you'll get 20% off the annual premium subscription. So go and check this out. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow.